Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we were discussing about this kind of architecture where we wanted to have authentication and authorization logic for the application. Okay, in this video we are going to talk about on the same line, like how we can orchestrate, how we can actually spin up all these different containers. It can be a simple example as like populating a default config file and having all these different microservices there. Okay, so what we are doing in this example is we just have these different microservices, okay, and we have Docker Compose file. We are using Docker Compose to actually run all these containers. So there is admin container, cart container, client container, and one is a proxy, which is Nginx container, which will help us to route the request which we are sending from the front end. So there is a front end and we are not using currently the auth providers like Firebase and Auth0, but it is good to have for your enterprise application which you are building. So what advantage you are getting is you don't need to worry about writing the logic of authentication for that, because now authentication is being done by Firebase and Auth0, which we have seen here, right? So you're just isolating this logic there, and now you are just getting the token, and that token you are passing to the respective microservice. And there will be a microservice to validate the token. Once that token is valid, you will be able to talk to your actual database and you will be able to get the data. So there are many options. I mean, you can actually spin up at these different microservices using Nest.js. These services are written with the help of Nest.js, means I just created one Docker Compose file to have all these containers. One is a MongoDB, one is a Redis. These can be three different microservices to just simulate this, and one is Nginx proxy. And if you want to have a front end also running through the Nginx, then you can create a front end and just expose the front end React or Angular build through the front end /route. Okay, I think, give me a second. This is the Nginx proxy file. What it is doing is, based on our request, it is forwarding the request to a particular service like auth APIs, admin APIs, or cart APIs. Okay, and here we have our Docker Compose YAML file. And Docker Compose YAML file contains all the respective containers we have in our system. So here we have like Nginx, which is a gateway. Okay, then we have MySQL container. Then we have Mongo container and authentication container, cart container, admin container for admin application, client container for client application, right? So gateway is our Nginx proxy. You can see here we are exposing this Nginx file and there that contains the routing. Okay, so this is a Docker Compose file we have seen. So Docker Compose file will be able to orchestrate all our containers, and this is how we will be able to establish communication. Now, you can actually use Nest.js for writing these microservices, which is a cart, authentication, admin, or client can be your React or Angular client. Okay, so what we will do is we will actually try to build this. We have already tried to build this kind of structure, but we can try doing this with the Firebase or Auth0. Okay, having the authentication system in your microservice is simple. You just need to use a JSON web token. And you just need to pass the payload and the secret. It will give you the token, and that token you can again send to your respective microservices to protect the APIs and the authorization header. Okay, let's see this structure getting built up from the scratch from the next video using Nest.js services.